one day, I fully intend to go and have me come over again very soon to play in my clothes for more. We live in the city, so you hear those things sometimes. And the fire truck, not a cop car. Today on YouTube, we're going to be listening to my It's a Vibe playlist. Nope, it's actually just called Vibe. It's called Vibe. You can go to Google Fiction or YouTube, my Google Fiction YouTube channel, and follow the Vibe playlist. And this is It's a Vibe by 2J and Ty Dolla $ign and Trey Phone and Janae Ivey.
And since we're promoting, I might as well promote my YouTube channel, Yay Stratton, because it is
Monologue Monday.
And it's also Black History Month.
It is Black History Month, so we are black.
And
we are not history, we are your presence.
But with that, I did a monologue from Fences this week.
You so, from Fences.
We're in by August 12th, and I did the roast.
Like,
I waited 18 years.
Right, I waited 18 years, Troy.
Yeah.
What about me?
So if you guys, you know, go to my page, you can see that video, watch it, comment, like it, share it, subscribe.
All of that. Do it on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Do you have a Twitter?
I don't know.
I'm a maker of Twitter, guys. She needs a Twitter.
I do not know what to do.
I tweet things.
I don't.
If you're not following
me,
you should.
So,
I had a Twitter made for me by my freshman year PA. Shout out to Beth from IUP, whose last name I don't remember, and she got married and changed it anyway, so her last name's not important. But she actually made my Twitter.
Oh, guys, I also had a couple gigs this past weekend. did background work for Madam Secretary.
That was an important thing. Listen, they were all important. They're all important. Everything she did this weekend was important. But Madam Secretary is on NBC.
Possibly. I definitely have to double check. I did look it up so that I can understand the story, but I don't know which network it's on.
It's on NBC, CBS, K-1. It's on Channel 36 or 10. It's one of those. So that's dope. I don't watch Madam Secretary, but I watch commercials, and I see commercials for Madam Secretary, so that's great.
Yeah, I watch some videos of it. It's pretty good. It was cool to be on set. I think that my biggest fascination was the set. Like, I was in love with the set because it's like, just to watch it all, like, what you see on TV is cool because it kind of creates that world, but when you're in, it's like, it's here, and then to know, like, it's kind of inside of, like, a building, and then outside is real outside. It's like, it's so fun to really step into a place, and then it kind of becomes something else. So I was one of the press, I actually was in the front row, on the right-hand side, I guess, for the actors on their left-hand side who were facing us. But it was cool. You know, we just did a little pantomime talking and, you know, chit-chat. And then at the end, we all yelled, Madam Secretary, Madam Secretary, you know. But it was cool. Like, if someone was reading my lips, they might be able to find out. No. But I do know people who used to do that just so it could look, but I still just ain't worried.
Because I think it's weird.
Even if I just say, I'm just going to talk words, I'm just going to talk words.
I usually do that. I usually go, this is me making a sentence that looks like we're talking, so that it looks like we're talking. Because it looks like we're talking.
So then, on the side note, though, for actors or performers or singers, I guess, what I do is that my vocal warm-up, I guess I can call it that, would be my Betsy Botcher and then my articulatory agility. So, Betsy Botcher, Botcher, Bitcher, Botcher, so Betsy says, Botcher, Bitcher, Botcher, and then my Batcher, it will make my Batcher, Bitcher. So Betsy Botcher, Botcher, Bitcher, Botcher, Botcher, and it makes her Batcher, Bitcher.
I like that.
And then my favorite is still articulatory agility, is developing the ability to effortlessly and believably utter clearly the most conceivably convoluted consonant combos in the world. Flexible lips and shrunken hug tips are needed to toss off Freudian quips, and who can dispute or relax? Lower jaw when spewing forth a torrent of Shaw. It takes superlative diction to theatrically mumble and clearly be misunderstood and jumbled. We had couplets to prose, we had these dumber joes from Shakespeare to Simon, from Molière to Mammoth. It simply won't do if they don't understand it. Which gets crazy. Takes all the breath. But they're fun. You know, I learned them in high school. We went to the Creative and Performing Arts High School, both of us. Oh, your eyes like started watering.
I'm gonna learn it! We went to Kappa.
I think I want to do this, but I got to be big up. Not too much. It's like, I said no.
Wait,
hello, my fear of her.
Would you please
I just like with this necklace. So, my boyfriend got me this necklace for our The Day We Met anniversary, which is October the 5th. And I haven't been able to wear it because I didn't have anything to wear it with. And I was like, oh, a leotard.
I like it.
So
I'm not a big fan of chunky necklaces. I like chokers.
You know I'm always a choker every day, girl.
More like the extra chain. The pin is like my robot. I have a robot pendant.
I have a robot pendant.
There's two of you now.
Right.
I'm talking about both of you.
You're talking about Jory that you like in necklaces.
But I like other people's chunky necklaces.
I like it to like do this.
And
I wish I could
like
do
it. Like a wind chime.
And it's like, even though it looks a little blue too, it's purple. And purple is my favorite color, and blue too. So, and blue's hers too.
Blue's my favorite color. And purple is my second favorite color. Actually, red's my second, and then purple's my third because we made purple with red. So this is like really close to the midnight purple. My favorite color is actually midnight blue, which is that purplish color that the actual silly night sky gets around like 2 o'clock in the morning, so it's not really midnight, but it's early morning night sky. My favorite color.
Early morning night sky.
Right. I'm gonna have someone actually make me this color, and then I'm gonna do like Jay-Z did and make it my own color and get coins. No one's allowed to steal that idea. No one. My idea.
So yeah, I don't know. We're listening to music, still Chris Brown. We don't own any of this music, we just like it.
Right.
And we thought it'd be a nice little background, because that's what we would do anyway if we were sitting here talking. So.
I'm a nerd, and I still make musical playlists.
So. I do. And I just listen to some music.
We can talk about the album cover art of Rick Warren's Full Moon.
Okay.
Which
with
is awesome.
Heart ripped open, kind of at the top, leaning down on top of like a pink,
sure
and a white moon, in the galaxy kind of deal.
Yes, I'm gonna show them because I was gonna take a picture and then I realized that y'all can see everything. So.
So she's gonna show you, but we're gonna edit it into the video so that you.
So this is actually Eric Bellinger, who I discovered on Spotify, but it is Malibu Nights.